Hello, fellow art nerds. My name is Felicia, and this is part two of learning the basics of Medibang Paint Pro. So I'm going to go through a few more tools in the program that will help you feel more confident and hopefully get you excited about doing digital art on a computer or a tablet. So if you haven't already, make sure to watch part one before you continue with this video. And if you already have, get your program open and ready so you can follow along with me as we make a fun drawing by the end. So let's get started. So when you open up Medibang, make sure you are working on a blank page. So to do that, I'm going to click up on File at the top and click on New. And I'm going to keep my measurements at 1080 width and 1080 height. And I'll just hit OK. So now we have our blank space to work with. So for anyone who loves Pokemon, today we're going to draw the face of Pikachu. He's our familiar little friend from the Pokemon TV series, video games, and card trading game. So you can follow along with me step by step as I show you how I draw him. So we'll make sure we have our brush tool selected. And I'm going to use the pen brush down here, and also make sure that you have a good size for your brush. So I think I'm going to put mine at around 15. So remember, you can use the slider to adjust the size here, or also pick one of the presets down at the bottom right corner. And before we start making any lines, I'm going to show you a feature that can help you really make smooth lines if you're worried about your pen being a little too shaky. And that is our pen correction. So right up at the top here, it says correction with a drop down. Mine is set to 20 right now. Yours is probably at 0. So if you set yours to 20, let's try and make a smooth line. When you have it turned on to anything that's not 0, your pen will help you make smoother lines and correct you as you draw. So if I go to 0, this is me drawing without correction. See, I'm a little wobbly there, but if I turn it on to 20 and draw the exact line, it's much straighter than the other one. And you can also see, if I turn it up to the max, when I draw, you see how my pen is slowly catching up to where I am? Kind of dragging along a bit. This is how we get our correction. When you click on the drop down menu here, there are lots of numbers, so the bigger the number, the smoother your line will be, but also the longer it will be dragging behind you. So a good number to keep this at is 20, just for a little support as we draw. So let's start drawing Pikachu. I'm going to move my pen and take it to the black color so I can line him. And the first step is to draw his head shape. So his head is round, but I find it is not exactly a circle. It kind of goes a bit longer than that. So I'm gonna make that shape here. Kind of like that. And see, with our correction on, it made a nice smooth line for me. So our second step is to draw his curved ears that come to a point. Like that. They kind of look like small surfboards. You want to look at it like that. There we go. And on his ears, we are going to draw small lines that go across like this. And this will be the black tips on his ears. And we'll color in those later. Now next we will draw his eyes. They are two small circles on the left and the right side. And in his eyes, they also have smaller circles on the inside. This gives him a little highlight to where his eyes are. I'm putting one on my left eye, moving it closer to the right side, and on my right eye, moving the smaller circle to the left. So they kind of come inward towards the middle. So our next step underneath that, we were going to draw a little triangle for his nose with the point facing down. And then we'll draw a small wave for his mouth. Just like that. And I'm going to have Pikachu's mouth open. So I will draw a long U shape that connects from the one side to the other. Just a long U. And we'll show his tongue in the middle. So we'll do another U, but facing the other way, kind of an upside down U. Like that. Now for our last step on Pikachu, we are going to draw two curves on both sides of his face, almost a half circle, to show those big cheeks that he has. And now we have our outline of Pikachu. So now we can go ahead and color him in. So remember, when we start coloring, we need another layer underneath our line layer. So here's our line. I'm going to double click and name it our line layer, hit OK. And to make another layer, we're going to hit this button down at the bottom, our first one on the bar, and click that. We are going to drag it underneath our line layer, and I will call this one color. All right, so make sure your lines are closed, just like mine, and there are no gaps, because we are going to grab our paint bucket tool. I think they're kind of thin up here, so I'm just gonna make sure that they're closed so we can use that paint bucket tool and fill them in. So on our color layer, make sure your color layer is selected. I'm going to grab my paint bucket and let's get that nice yellow that Pikachu is. And we're gonna click on each layer where he's yellow, just like that. Now I left those tips on there because those are supposed to be black. So let's grab our black and click, all right. And same with his eyes too here. We are going to leave these small circles white and fill the rest in black, just like that. Now he's starting to look like him. All right, and then I'm going to grab a red for his cheeks. So I think this is a good color for him. And we'll do a light pink for his tongue and a dark pink for the inside of his mouth. Now, you see, I left out a cheek on Pikachu. And now I don't know what color I had before. I'm not sure what red it was. And I want to know exactly what red I used for his cheek so I can match it on the other side. So if I missed a spot and I would like to go back and fill it in, there's a tool that will help me when I need to know what color of my drawing it is. So the tool up here we're going to use is on our toolbar here, and it is this eyedropper tool right above the hand you see here. I'm going to click on that. Now we have an eyedropper as our tool. So anywhere we click, if you look at the color at the top there, it will select it. So now I have yellow and black and pink and red. So it will click anywhere I click will grab that color for me. So this comes in handy if you were to do a mistake like I did, and I'll need to grab that red there. So if I go back to my paint bucket with that red selected, I can go in and fill it with the exact same red that I used before. So if you ever need to grab the same color again or a part of your drawing, you don't have to guess what it was. This tool will do all the work for you very quickly. So now that we have our Pikachu, I would like to be able to move him around my page. So I will talk about the Move tool, which is right by our toolbar here. It's this compass shape with arrows that are pointing up, down, left, and right. This is our Move tool. So let's click on that. Now the move tool allows us to click on any layer that we have selected and move it around our page. So if I were to click and drag on this layer, this is our color layer, but I don't want both of our layers to be separated. I want both of these to stay together as we have our whole drawing here. So since we have two layers that I don't want to separate, I'm going to create a folder within our layers so they can both stay together. So that is this button down here in the middle, right where you see our layers, it's this folder. Let's click on that. So now we have a folder. I'm going to move it to the top of our stack. And if I click and drag on one of the layers and move it in over top, see how it highlights all in blue around? I'll let go. And now our color layer is inside of this folder we just created. So I'll click and drag our line one as well and move it into the folder. And now I have both the line and the color in this folder. If you click on the folder icon here, you can close it up and click on it again to reopen it. So I'm going to double click and call this one Pikachu. This is our drawing in here. So folders are great if you need to organize your drawings too. So if you have too many layers in your list, you can also make a folder and then name it by double clicking on it. And this will help you not get too confused on which layer is which, and it can be really fast to grab them if you need to. So now that I have both of my layers in this folder, and I still have my move tool selected, if I click and drag now, both layers will be selected. And now I can move it wherever I want. So if I wanted to move it down here, or maybe up at the top, I can. I'm just going to leave it right in the middle, but this is very handy for other drawings that you're making. So now that we have our Pikachu face here, I would like to put mine in a shape or a frame in the background, but I would like to have my lines perfect without using a brush. And there is a shape tool that we can use just to do that. And back on our toolbar here, we are going to click this icon here. It's called the shape brush tool. It's right underneath our eraser. So let's click on that. And this tool can make perfect lines, circles, and rectangles just by clicking and dragging. So if we take a look at the top, these are our different options that we can choose from. We'll talk about this first one here, the line. So we will click on this line tool here. Now, if I were to drag out a line, now since we have a folder, we don't want to have our folder selected anymore. We now want to create a new layer. So I'm going to make a layer within my folder, and I'm just going to drag it to the bottom here, and I will put it into my folder. I want it to be the background, so I'm just rearranging my layers. Make sure you always have your line layer at the top, then your color, and then your background. So I will double click on this and name it background, just so I don't get confused. And now we're going to be working on our background layer. So make sure that when you use this shape brush tool, you always have a layer selected and not the folder. If you have the folder selected, it just won't work, and you might be a bit confused to why it's not working. Just make sure you have a layer selected. So now let's take a look at this line tool up here. So we'll have this selected. So now that we have our background layer, I can click and drag anywhere on my page to bring this long line anywhere. I'm still clicking and dragging to move this preview line. So if I were to let go at any time, it will make a line exactly where the preview was before. So see this line? This will show us where the line's gonna go. So if I wanted to make a small one, I can just let go here and it will make one for me. So if you want to make a straight line, but you just can't get it perfect, this will come in handy. And this also depends on the size of your brush. So my size is 15 here. If I make it very small and do it again, the line will come out a lot more thin than the one I had before. I will bring it to 12 for now. So another one we can try out is the rectangle tool. So we'll skip these two other line ones here. These ones are a bit more advanced, so I won't talk about them yet, but this rectangle tool will help you a lot. So we'll click on this one here, and it's very similar to the line tool. All you have to do is click anywhere on your page and drag out your rectangle. You can make it small or really wide and big, anywhere you want. So if I let go here, now my Pikachu is within a square, and I didn't have to go in and draw those lines. It did it perfectly for me and very quickly. And this also applies to the circle tool up here as well. So we'll click on the circle one. And again, if I click and drag anywhere on my page, a big circle will pop out. And if I let go, now Pikachu is in a circle. So actually, I will keep the circle since I like how that looks for my Pikachu. And remember, you can move your layer by hitting the move tool. If you click on that, maybe you didn't like how your shape came out or where it was on the page, you can move it around so you can center it to where you would like, or center the whole entire thing on your page as well. I'm going to move these to the center. So now I have my frame here, and I would like to make this color a blue color for Pikachu. So I'm going to grab my background layer that has this circle on it. I'm going to hit the paint bucket right on my circle. Now I have a blue line going through it. And I also want to have the inside of the circle colored. So I'm going to hit the background there. And now it's all filled again too. So now I really like my circle, but I'd like to add some stripes in it too. So instead of just taking my brush like this and making straight lines with my pen, I can make perfectly straight lines with the shape tool. So when we click on the shape tool, we'll click on the line one right up here, and we can click and drag to make those nice straight lines. I'm just going from top to bottom, making my lines, clicking and dragging. Now also remember, if you want a certain color from your drawing from before, so maybe you wanted to have a red background, remember you can use the eyedropper tool at the bottom. Click on the eyedropper, and if you click anywhere, it will pick up any color that you have on your page, even the white. If you click on the white space here, it will pick the white as well. So I still want my blue, so I'm just going to click up on the top there. So now we have our Pikachu in a little background or a frame to put him in. So now he's not just on a white page, we have something that looks really nice in the end. And this is with using our eyedropper tool, our move tool, and our shape tool. And we also learned about using layer folders in here, using our line, color, and background, and putting them all into a folder. So this also organizes our work and makes our project much cleaner. This is one of a four-part mini course on Medibang for beginners. I teach digital art camps and classes at Wing Canvas, so check out our website for online programs. If you'd like to support our channel or the creation of free arts education, become a member of our Patreon, link in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, here are some other videos that you can check out next.